Good afternoon to everybody. Welcome to the today class, law of property, that I was dealing yesterday, or either I can say the ideal test today, the wills, where I said the nature of the bequest in the last class, that is in Saturday, and yesterday was a Sunday, and today is Monday, and Monday that I would like to deal the types of wills. Yes, before I could proceed it, I would like the confirmation from you that whether you could be able to see the screen or not. If you have seen it, please unmute and read what I kept on the screen, what I posted on the screen. Yes, anyone?
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Single will, need a will, living will, joint will, holographic will, deathbed will, what kind? Professor Dr. Mohammad Sahib Hussain.
Yes, these are the types of the will. This is how I posted in the today's posting, but again I changed it from the good morning to good afternoon, and these are the wills generally that we are going to deal today. So without wasting my time, let us come to the point of the types of the wills are concerned, or the kinds of the will. Then we can say that what is the difference between the kinds of wills and the type of will? Any idea? Yes.
Probably same, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes you will say types, sometimes you will say kind. But depend upon the context, the things which you want to make it out. And we will change the wordings. Okay, let us come to the types of the wills are concerned. The privileged and underprivileged wills. That is A, B is contingent, virtual conditional wills. C, joint wills. D, mutual wills. E, duplicate wills. F, holographic wills. G, current. Concurrent wills, H, sham wills. These are the generally the wills we will study in the Indian context. But when you see the different contexts, they do have some other will, like a living will is there. Living, L-I-V-I-N-G, living wills also there, and which are said to be connected with the medical terminology. Yes, so let us see that what we know, these things, A to H, let us discuss one each one in detail. That A, the privileged and unprivileged wills. Yes. Indian Section Act 1925 provides certain privileges to a soldier, an airman, and a mariner at sea employed in an expedition or engaged in actual warfare. So, for these people, there is a separate privilege is given them because they are on the war ground, like the soldiers. What do you mean by soldier? Yes.
Sir, Desha Bhaktudu, Sainikudu.
So, what is a soldier and army difference?
Soldier may be an army, an air force, and navy. Three types.
Right. Anywhere. But an airman?
Airman is only for air force, sir.
Very good. And a mariner?
Mariner may be navy, sir. Navy.
Yes, yes. Let's see the sailing and voyage that is said, employed in expedition or engaged in actual warfare. So these privileges are enacted keeping in mind the complicated predicament a soldier is under during the tenure of his service. So the provisions pertaining to such privileges are mentioned under the section 66 of the Indian Succession Act, and such wills are called the privileged wills. Because there is certain privilege is given over there, even they make the oral will also that is valid. The section 65 of the Indian Succession Act 1925 provisions allowing the word of mouth in the presence of a witnesses to be considered as a valid will. Even a word of mouth in the presence of the witnesses to be considered as a valid will, and written instruction to be considered as a valid will after the death of a soldier are some of the prime example of such privileges. Even the soldier at the wartime or at the time of the either the Navy or the Air Force, if they could make the oral will also from their mouth in the presence of the witnesses, it is considered to be the will, and it is a written instruction to be considered as a valid will. So as if that is the written instructions was given over there, so the oral will will be considered in that way even after the death of the soldier are some of the prime example of such a privilege. So, wills created by a testator not being a soldier, suppose if you are not a soldier or an airman or a mariner at sea, employed in an expedition or engaged in actual warfare are known as a privileged will. So unprivileged wills, these are all known as. So unprivileged wills are governed under the section 63 of the act. So wills created by trusted not being a soldier or an airman or a mariner. So if they are not a soldiers or airmen or mariners and at sea employed in an expedition, engaged in actual warfare. So for these people, other than these people, we can say is the unprivileged wills. So unprivileged wills are governed under section 63 of the act. So privileged wills only for the soldiers, mariners and navy people, and unprivileged is other than these people, actually those who are not at the time of the war. At that instance, we can say they do have the unprivileged wills, because that will be the usual wills what an ordinary man supposed to do. So the privileged wills and unprivileged wills clearly mentioned in the Indian Succession Act in the different sections. So that is the one type of the will. So why this privileged will? Can you tell me?
Sir, some special immunities, I think, sir.
In the war, they may die or they what they do. If they before die or if the time of the war, if they could make such a will, it is enough. That is deemed to be the written will. So other than this time, then we can make, then at that time we can say unprivileged will. So that is governed by 63 of the act. So now let us see the B, contingent and conditional wills. So here execution of these wills are dependent on the happening of an event. And if that event occurs in the future only, then the will is to become effective. So some future contingent event should be there. If that event is going to be materialized, then automatically this will be effective. So these wills are created for multiple purposes. If the testator wants to motivate a loved one for doing something good, like my son will get my property only if he graduates from his law school with a 70% score. Suppose if the father makes such a statement that if you score the 70% in the law school, that I am going to give this the form of a will to you. Or want to make a safe appropriation of his property in case of his death while touring abroad. So any conditions they will make it out and they will give the will, and such a will is said to be the contingent will. So he can make a contingency regarding the same in his will. Any condition which is contrary to the law is invalid in nature, cannot be incorporated in will. Suppose you should not keep such a condition that if you walk for 100 miles per hour, then this will be given to you. Can you keep such a will, the contingent will?
No, yes, sir.
Why?
No. Because it depends upon the voluntary, no, sir. It is a voluntary act, not an forcible act, no, sir.
No, this is also voluntary act. No, if you pass, if you score in the law school 70% scoring, then I am going to give this will to you.
That is a positive. That is a positive kind of affirmation. So.
But what about this thing that if you walk 100 miles per hour, then I can give this will to you?
That is a conditional, no, sir. That is a condition.
Both are condition, but one is impossible condition that we kept it.
Yes, sir.
Walking 100 miles per hour is an impossible condition. It cannot be materialized unless until he is having some magic power. So impossible things and the condition should be in such a way, it should not be contrary to the public policy and it should not be invalid in nature, and then only we can keep such a will. Otherwise we should not keep such a contingent or conditional wills. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Suppose the sun sets in the east, then I am going to give this will. Is it a valid will?
No, sir, it is not at all valid.
Why?
Because it is impossible.
So sun sets where?
Sun rises in east, sun sets in west, sir.
Yeah, that is the thing which is impossible thing over there, which is contrary in the nature, such a way conditions with the invalid conditions, and the will is not a valid will. That is the contingent and conditional wills are concerned. Suppose if you are going to marry a particular girl, okay, I am going to give you this thing. Okay, this will be a valid will because contingency is there, unless until there is a pressure on him and he doesn't like it. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next is C is joint wills. So let us see joint. Joint itself means even two or more people agree to make a conjoint will, such a testamentary document are known as joint wills. So how many testators are here in joint will?
Maybe two or more, sir.
How many beneficiaries?
Beneficiaries also two or more.
Why two? Why not one?
One plus, sir.
Why one plus? The two testators make the joint will to a particular only one person.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, it may be two. The only joint will means testators are two.
Intestators are many.
No, beneficiary many.
Yes, sir.
One or many doesn't make any difference. It is. You can give the will to one person or you can give the will to the mass also, a group also, yes, either equally or proportionately.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, when two or more people agree to make a conjoint will, such a testamentary documents are known as joint wills. These are generally created between a married couples with an intention to leave the property to their spouse after one of them dies. So they will make the joint. If one of them dies, then other will belongs to the other partner, other spouse. A joint will can also be created with an intention to take effect after the death of all the testators. Even there also, they can make all the testators together will make three or four, make it the will. So in such a joint will, till all the testators are alive, a single testator cannot revoke the will alone. So in the joint will, one testator cannot revoke it, because suppose only one is left among the testators, then he can revoke it. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
He or she would require the consent of other testator to revoke the joint will. Suppose three or four joint will is there, so they have to take the rest of the people consent to revoke it. Only when all other testators have died, so when all other testators have died, the sole surviving testator can revoke the will alone. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
You suppose there are three or four testators are there, joint will make it out. The three of them died, then only one is survived. The four are there, the three of them died, only one survived, he can revoke it because he is the sole partner, owner of the will.
Yes, sir.
So that is a joint will. So there the beneficiary either one or more than one doesn't make any difference there. So whatever the beneficiary is a minor.
Until he attains the majority, that means until he minority is completed, he is under the guardian, sir.
On behalf of the minor, the guardian will take care of it. Once he emancipated, either he want to revoke it, he may accept it. Depends upon his discretion. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So D, mutual wills. So mutual wills are the kind of wills in which two people agree to formulate a will on the mutually agreed terms and conditions. The testator creates the other person as his or her legatee in these wills. Generally, a married couple who have children from their first marriage creates such a will to ensure the interest of those children. The terms and conditions of the will remain binding on the surviving partners after the death of the first partner. Mutual will helps to ensure that the property passes on to the children of the deceased and not a new spouse of this surviving partner in case they remarry. So when the mutual wills will come across, that means it is the mutual wills are the kinds of wills in which two people agree to formulate a will on the mutually agreed terms and conditions. What is the terms and condition there? The testator creates the other person or his or her legatee in this will. So here, suppose the spouse is there. The husband is having the second wife and the wife is having the second husband. If such a case would be there, so mutually they can give to their former wife children or former husband children. So the testator creates the other person as his or her legatee in these wills. So generally married couples who have children from their first marriage, see, the wording they used is, the married couples who have children from their first marriage. Means both are
already married, sir.
Both are already married, having the children, again they married.
Yes, sir.
Yes, because either they left it or they are widow or might be any other reason. So, such a people, those who already married over there, create such a will to ensure that the interest of the children, either former children, so, or the, generally the former children, means former wife or former husband's children. The terms and conditions of the will remains binding on the surviving partners of after the death. So, whatever the surviving partners are there, means surviving partners in the sense here, the children of these new second married people. And these are after the death of the first partners, means any one of the partners is dead over there among it. So, mutual will helps to ensure that the property passes on the children of the deceased and not a new spouse of the surviving partners. So, surviving partner and new spouse, for their children will not go in the case they remarry. Suppose in the case they remarry also, the outcome that children, those who are coming, it no, it will not go to them. It will go to only the former husband or wife children it goes. Means first wife or first husband children it goes, because it is mutually agreed by the two people, those who wants to give the property to them. So this is a mutual wills, they agree to give, because when they are already married, at that instance only such wills will be created. Okay? అది మీకు చెప్పాను చూడండి ఒకసారి మీకు మనం స్టేక్ ఇన్ ద క్లాసెస్ ఐ ద లవ్ టాట్ అవర్ ఇన్ అదర్ ప్లేసెస్ ఏమండి ఏమండి మీ మీ పిల్లలు నా పిల్లలు కలిసి మన పిల్లలను కొడుతున్నారు
ఫారెన్ లో సార్ ప్రిపేర్ సార్
వాట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్
అని చెప్పారు సార్ దట్ మీన్స్ బోత్ ఆర్ మ్యారీడ్
బోత్ ఆర్ మ్యారీడ్ అగైన్ దే మ్యారీడ్ బికాజ్ బోత్ ఆర్ హావింగ్ ద ఫార్మర్ హస్బెండ్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ డివోర్స్ ఆర్ Whatever it makes the reason or died, again they married, the first wife, first husband's children, and the other wife, the first former husband's children, they do have it. And these people again, they have their own children. That's the reason your children and our children's beating, sorry, your children's and my children's are beating our children. So that was the mutual wills will come at that instance. So now the duplicate wills. Duplicate in the sense, sir, డూప్లికేట్ అనాలా సార్ జిరాక్స్ విల్ అనాలా అండి ఎస్
నాట్ రియల్ సార్ నాట్ రియల్
యాజ్ ద నేమ్ సజెస్ట్ వెన్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ కాపీస్ ఆఫ్ ఎ విల్ దోస్ విల్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ డూప్లికేట్ విల్స్ ఎస్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద టూ కాపీస్ ఆఫ్ ది విల్ ఆల్దో ఇట్ ఈస్ కన్సిడర్డ్ ఎ సింగిల్ విల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ సింపుల్ టు క్రియేట్ ఎ డూప్లికేట్ ఆఫ్ ది విల్ ద టెస్టేట్ హ్యాస్ టు మేక్ ఎ సెకండ్ కాపీ ఆఫ్ ది విల్ and shall sign it and get it attested in the way that he did it for the original will as per section 63 of the Indian Succession Act 1925. So, photocopy will, that is, a duplicate will in another way. But we don't say photocopy will, or we, preferably we will add the duplicate will. Manam even duplicate keys antam. Ante original key vere untai, duplicate keys vere untai. Is it not? Yes? టెల్ మీ అయితే వేరే చోట్ల ఏమంటారు అంటే డూప్లికేట్ కీ అంటారు దాన్ని ఏమంటారు కాపీ కీ కీ కాపీ ఆర్ కాపీ కీ అంటారు కీ కాపీ బట్ ప్రిఫరబుల్లీ డూప్లికేట్ కీ ఇస్ ఎ వెరీ అప్రోప్రియట్ వన్ వన్ కాపీ కెన్ బి కెప్ట్ విత్ ద టెస్టేటర్ అండ్ అదర్ మైట్ బి కెప్ట్ ఇన్ ద సేఫ్ కస్టడీ సమ్వేర్ లైక్ ఇన్ ఏ బ్యాంక్ లాకర్ విత్ ఎ ట్రస్టీ ద డ్రాఫ్టింగ్ అటార్నీ ఆర్ విత్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటర్ ఇప్పుడు మన తెలుగు సినిమాల్లో చూస్తూ ఉంటాం ఏది చనిపోయిన తర్వాత ఏమైంది కొన్ని రోజుల తర్వాత ఏమొస్తాడు వాళ్ళ ఫ్యామిలీ అడ్వకేట్ వస్తాడు ఎందుకంటే అది ఇక్కడ వాళ్ళ దగ్గర డిపాజిట్ చేసి ఉంటుంది సో నౌ యూ విల్ డీ యువర్ ఫాదర్ హ్యాస్ రిటర్న్ చేసి సచ్ విల్ అని అందరిని పిలిపించి చదువుతాడు అన్నట్టు ఓకే యా ద టెస్టేటర్ విత్ ద ఇంటెన్షన్ టు ప్రొటెక్ట్ ద ఎగ్జిక్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ది విల్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద డెత్ మేక్స్ ఏ కాపీ ఆఫ్ ది విల్ సో ఎందుకు అంటే కాపీ చేస్తారంటే బెటర్ టు హ్యావ్ ద టూ కాపీస్ సో వన్ కాపీ విత్ ద టెస్టేటర్ అనదర్ కాపీ ఐదర్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాంక్ లాకర్ ఆర్ విత్ ద అడ్వకేట్ ఆర్ విత్ రిజిస్టర్ డిపాజిటెడ్ ఇన్ ద ఐరన్స్ ఫైర్ ప్రూఫ్ ఐరన్ బాక్స్ Yeah, the testator with the intention to protect the execution of the will after his death makes a copy of the will. If the testator destroys the copy of the will and he has in his custody, then that would be automatically revoke other will. Suppose testator destroys the will. How the will can be destroyed? I told you in my last class. Yes.
Burn, sir.
By burning, number one. Number two.
No, sir. I know only one.
Chairing. Chearing. Chimpedo.
Yes, sir. Sir.
That's the second one. Inka moodadi uda cheppanu nenu. Navli tinedidam.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Suppose some secret would be there of any company or any other equation is there. The people wants to take it away. That fellow, what he does know, that he swallows it. He will munch it. He will chew it like a chewing gum. And he swallows it. So that can be destroyed in such a way. A duplicate wills are strong and valid proof of the testamentary objective until the original will is not on record. So otherwise, the authenticity of the duplicate will remains the questionable. Presumption is that the original will stands revoked will prevail in case original will is not filed with the duplicate copy in petition of the probate. So naturally, the duplicate copy that the probate cannot be made it over there, but only at that instant can be made when the original will is not traced out. Then duplicate will be traced out. Even the all the heirs will produce the same at that instant, that can be taken into consideration. Otherwise, they will ask the this is the only duplicate copy, and you get the original copy. Okay, you find the original copy. Suppose the only original copy is not found over there, then naturally, after some time, with the verification and due investigation, the court will get it. Yes, this is the original. This is the nothing but deemed to the probate of the original copy. It make the pass an order that is called a probate. So duplicate wills are strong and valid proof of this testamentary objective until the original will is not on record. So when the original will is not on record, at that time the duplicate will be strong and is a valid proof for testamentary objectives. And the authenticity of the duplicate will remain questionable. Of course, sometimes it's a questionable also. Presumption that the original will stands revoked will prevail in case of original will is not filed. Suppose if the original will is found at that instance, naturally the same copy, yes, it will be authenticated because original will is the copy of the same, which is the duplicate one. So filed with the duplicate copy in position of the probate. So original will is not found over there at the time the probate, they will consider it a duplicate is a valid one. So that was the thing. Unless until the specific thing will come out, then the presumption is that it is set to be the original will, even though it is not a original will, because the original will is not traced out. And that's the reason it is having a strong reason it is a valid will. Then the next is the holographic wills. So let us see what is the holographic wills. Wills which are handwritten by the testator himself are known as holographic wills. So there is no particular pro forma to write the wills. You can write in any manner that you like it. But only the thing is, the writing should be in the language known to the testator, number one. And there will be two witnesses, those who could understand the language which is written over there. And it is read over there, and these people heard it and they will attest it. And the two witnesses should be also competent witnesses, means sane mind, having the majority, and they following the, all the conditions which are needed for the for making the valid contract. So these witnesses may be male or female, doesn't make any difference. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, these kinds of will have their own merit. Which one? Holographic will, that means orally, written by the testator himself. So due to the fact that they are completely handwritten by the testator himself, rises a strong presumption pertaining to their regularity and execution. It is held on various judicial pronouncement that if there is hardly any suspicious circumstances attached to the will, it will require very little evidence to prove that the execution and attestation of such a will. So naturally, even a handwritten will, whether the witnesses are needed?
No need, sir.
Generally, no. There is witnesses are not there also, still it can be a valid will, because it is authenticated one, and it is there is no suspicious ground, and he himself with a sound mind that he wrote the will, and it will require very little evidence. See the wording they say, the very little evidence to prove the due execution and attestation of such a will. Means even without the attestation also that would be said to be the valid will, because there is a very little evidence to prove due execution and attestation of such a will. So holographic will is nothing but yes,
handwritten sir.
By whom?
Testator.
That is the wording you should have to return it. The testator handwritten wills are called holographic wills. Yes, G. Concurrent wills. Normally, a testator prepares a single will for his or her testamentary declaration. The testator, according to this wish, or for the sake of the convenience, can make different wills for the property located in different geographical locations. Hence, coexisting wills dealing with the testamentary declaration of a single testator are known as a concurrent will. Suppose if he is having the property in Ahmedabad and having the property in Bhadradri Kotagudam, then he can prepare the two wills in two geographical area. And such a wills are said to be the concurrent wills. How many testators are there? Yes?
Concurrent, more than one, sir.
Only one testator. But the geographical area, subject matter is?
More than one.
So that is the thing which they will say. Such a wills are coexisting wills dealing with the testamentary declaration of a single testator. See, clearly I told, single testator are known as a concurrent will. There is no double testator here. Not joint testator here. This is a single testator. Suppose if they write married or unmarried. So, people write now, married, unmarried, they don't write unmarried, they say single. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that means you understood what I mean. Okay, I come to the next point is H, sham wills. Yes, when you say the sham wills, these wills are created for an ulterior motive which is not the testamentary operations and execution of the will. So, in the sham will, there is no real intention to give the property in the form of a will to the another person. And rather it is in most cases, these wills are created for an immoral purpose, like acquiring a property that does not belong to the claimant and deceiving the someone, or one of the essential features of the valid will is the intention of the testator. These wills are supplemented with all other necessary documents to duly execute the collateral purposes, not to execute the will according to the testamentary operations. Suppose if you get this property and I am going to give this will to you, and that property which you are acquiring is illegal property and it is no more, it belongs to him as an encroached property, that is, and he is no more the owner of that property, but he wants to acquire it by using their own technique. So if such a wills are made, then the sham wills, it is not a valid at all. So these wills are created for an ulterior motive. What is the ulterior motive? Which is not the testamentary operation and execution of the will. But if you see the intentionally, there is no testamentary operation and execution of this will would be there. Just they will say that, yes, we are going to give this property to you, provided we acquire such a property by the court, or in the process of it, or later part of it. So rather in most cases, what the example they said is, in the most cases, these wills have created, how they created? The wills are created for an immoral purpose, like acquiring the property that does not belong to the claimant. That property which did not belong to the claimant, but he wants to acquire it by hook and crook, deceiving someone, etc. So, by making the fraudulent means and deceiving people and acquire such a property, they will make the sham wills. One of the essential features of a valid will is that, actually the feature of the valid will is that there should be intention on the part of the testator to give that property, either movable or immovable property, in the form of a will. So these wills are supplemented with all necessary documents to duly execute the collateral purposes and not to execute the will according to the testamentary operations. So these are, of course, collaterally they will make it out whether the collateral making such a condition is a valid condition or not, whether the purposive or not, depending upon that one only the sham wills are there. In one word, in another word, sham wills are not executed. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Why it is not executed? Tell me.
Sir, it is a immoral. That means the claimant will not having any
right over the property.
Right over the property.
So that is the way we can make it out. These are the types of the will. But I already told you that living will also there. Living wills. I will throw light on that. That is types of will. Yeah. They are said to be the living wills. Yeah, these are the types of this. See, here we know what is the privileged will. It is only army people will get the privileged will. Other than the army, in the ordinary times we can say unprivileged will for other people. So what is for ours is unprivileged wills. What we are doing is every person who is not entitled to make a privileged will can only make an unprivileged will. Means we civilians are unprivileged will, but the army people are
privileged will.
But only Hindu can only make an unprivileged will. Essential procedural requirement or unprivileged will must be summed up. That is, must be in writing, signed by the testator in the presence of the witnesses, signed by the two or more witnesses in presence of the testator, relevant section of the Indian Section Act 1925, read as follows. Other than the army and navy and other people are called unprivileged wills. Okay? And formal wills, they say. And the formal will in the sense, they are very, you just need to have sound mind of a person having the more than 18 years old, then you can make the formal wills, means ordinary wills. This is nothing but a unprivileged wills one can make. Handwritten wills, that is called holographic wills. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
And oral wills, oral will also can be done only by the privileged people. Of course, in the Muslim law, the oral will is valid over there. So that is also orally. Joint and mutual wills. Yeah, joint wills we studied and mutual wills we are studied. And a conditional also we studied and a contingent wills also we studied orally. Then statutory wills, this we are not studied. Even the statute itself will clearly mention the will. A statutory will is one that contains the standard terms provided by the state laws or central laws. But we don't have such a statutory wills. And of course, if the will is proved over there, then we can say it is a probate. So there is no such a thing, but only one thing is very much clear. A person who is a competent and the owner of the property can make a will. That way you can say. And a self-proving will, but we don't, it is another way of it. A self-proving will or a self-proving affidavit attached to a will must be notarized and certified that the witnesses and the testator properly signed the will. It is nothing but a documentary will in another way, because any will better to avoid the legal complication, it should be written. And it should be registered. That is a very good. This is the living will. I told you, that is the advanced medical directives will. That is called a living will. So this living will, unlike other types of the wills, a living will does not distribute property after the death of the testator. Instead, it gives an instruction on what type of the medical treatment you wish to receive if you become too ill to communicate. So that is the advanced medical directives living will. Suppose what the treatment that you should be given over there and which hospital that you will be treated over there before you could not able to give your communicate with you. For example, you might state that if you become a terminally ill and unconscious, you don't want to be hooked up with a feeding tube even if you would die without it. The formal requirement for the living will are more flexible than for the testamentary will, but it should be clear and detailed. Of course, advanced medical technology, AMD. That is advanced medical technology, that is AMD, is a set of the instructions that are given by the person about the level of the permission and is she willing to give the doctors about his body. So, to whom he should have to give the body? Sometimes you know the body will be given to the medical college. For what?
Sir, lab is sir.
Then you want to?
Avayava dhanam antar sir. Body organ donation. ఆర్గన్ డొనే ఆర్గన్ డొనేషన్
ఇంకొకటి కెడావర్ అంటారు దాన్ని.
కెడావర్
కెడావర్ CADAVER ఇక్కడ పెడతాను. లా బుక్స్ ఆర్ ఫర్ ద లాయర్ అండ్ కెడావర్ ఫర్ ద కెడావర్ ఫర్ ద డాక్టర్స్ కెడావర్ దాన్ని కెడావర్ అంటారు. ఇక్కడ చూడండి కిన్నది ఎక్కడ చదవండి.
A cadaver or corpse is a dead human body that is used by medical students, physicians, and other scientists to study anatomy, identify the diseases, sites, determine cause of death, and provide tissue to repair a defect in a living human being. Others who study cadavers include archaeologists and artists.
Yes, దాన్ని కెడావర్స్ అంటారు. కొత్తవాడు తెలుసుకున్నారా అండి, పాతవాడేనా ఇది మీకు?
కొత్తదే సార్. నేను ఆర్గన్ డొనేషన్ అనేది తెలుసు సార్ నాకు అంతే.
ఇది మెడికల్ వాళ్ళకి ఇచ్చేస్తారు. మై డెత్ ఆఫ్టర్ మై డెత్ లెట్ మై బాడీ విల్ బి యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ ద మెడికల్ పర్పసెస్ సో దే విల్ గివ్ ఫర్ ద కెడావర్స్ దాన్ని అంటారు అన్నట్టు. సో అది పిఎండి అనే లివింగ్ విల్, అది ఇది వేరే ఉంటుంది. సో దిస్ వే దట్ వీ కెన్ మేక్ ఇట్ ద విల్స్. సో దట్స్ వై ఐ పోస్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద టుడేస్ పోస్టింగ్ వన్ యు ఆర్ ఇంటిమేటింగ్ దట్ టుడే ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు ద క్లాస్. ఇఫ్ యూ మిస్ మై క్లాస్ యూ మిస్ మెనీ థింగ్స్ ఇన్ అడిషన్ టు ద సబ్జెక్ట్. డిడ్ ఐ మెన్షన్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్?
Yes, sir.
So, don't miss my class because my class is having a tremendous information to you to make it out. So, this is the one way that I want to like to make it out. Then I use the thank you word also here. But I will search it where I put it there. Thank you. Yes. This is the thank you especially I want to make. Yeah, read what is the thank you which I wrote there.
Dhanyavadamulu. Thank you. In appreciation of you and all that you do. Thanks for your patience, watching, listening and participating in my online class without fear. Professor Dr. Muhammad Saheb Hussain.
ఇక్కడ నేను స్పెల్లింగ్ మిస్టేక్ చేశాను, మీరు గుర్తు పెట్టిందా?
ధన్యవాదములు, కరెక్ట్ ఉంది. పార్టిసిపేటింగ్
ఇక్కడ లిసనింగ్ అన్న కాడ ఐఎన్జి జి మిస్ అయింది చూడండి.
లేదు సార్, జీ లేదు.
అయితే మనం బ్రెయిన్ ఎట్లాంటిది అంటే బ్రెయిన్ మొత్తం తీసుకోదు, అది ఒక్కటసారి గుంపు గుంపుగా తీసుకొని అది సీజ్ చేస్తుంది. అందుకోసమే అందులో ఒకరు మీరు ఈ మిస్ చేసినా టీ మిస్ చేసినా ఏదన్నా ఒక రెండు మూడు లెటర్లు మిస్ చేసిన ఆర్ జంబులు చేసిన యువర్ మైండ్ విల్ రీడ్ దిస్ లిస్నింగ్. అది ఫాలోయింగ్
కేర్ఫుల్ అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తేనే కేర్ఫుల్ అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తేనే తెలుస్తుంది సార్.
లేకుంటే ఏమైందంటే రీడ్ చేసేస్తాం మనం, జంబులు ఉన్నా రీడ్ చేసేస్తాం. ఈ పేషెంట్స్ కి పేషెంట్ కి డిఫరెంట్ ఏమున్నదండి?
పేషెంట్స్ అంటే ఓపిక్ గా ఉండాలని సార్. పేషెంట్ అంటే హీ మే బి డిసీజ్డ్.
ఇక్కడ చూడండి పెట్టాను పేషియంట్స్ అండ్ పేషెంట్స్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ద పేషియంట్స్ అండ్ పేషెంట్స్? ఇక్కడ పేషియంట్స్ అంటే పేషెంట్స్ ఆర్ పీపుల్ రిసీవింగ్ ఆర్ రిజిస్టర్డ్ టు రిసీవ్ ద మెడికల్ ట్రీట్మెంట్. ఏది PATIENTS? అది PATIENCS అంటే ఏంటిది? పేషియన్స్ ఈస్ ద కెపాసిటీ టు యాక్సెప్ట్ ఆర్ టాలరేట్ డిలే ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆర్ సఫరింగ్ విదౌట్ బికమింగ్ ఎన్నాయిడ్ ఆర్ యాంగ్షియస్. సో పేషియన్స్ అండ్ పేషెంట్స్, సీ దీస్ ఆర్ ద టూ డిఫరెన్సెస్ విల్ బి దేర్. అండ్ హియర్ పేషియన్స్ ఇది పైకి వెళ్ళి కింది పడుతుంది చూడండి, ఇది టైం ఫాలోవర్. సో యూ షుడ్ హ్యావ్ ద పేషెన్స్ హియర్. హియర్ పేషియన్స్ మీన్స్ దే ఆర్ going to the medical treatment and these are the patients. So this is the difference where you could find it in the patients and patient, isn't it Arnold?
Yes sir.
Yeah, so with this today of the kinds of the wills that you have studied over there, then if you happen to see the syllabus then you will find what is missing here. Okay, thank you that I made it out already. then syllabus, that we can make it out, because the syllabus they did not get mentioned totally what the is there, because they are generally they have given specifically the wordings. So if you happen to see the syllabus here and see that will is there, codicil we studied, capacity to execute the will we studied, and the kinds of the wills we studied, nature of the bequest we studied, and executors of the will, means a person who executes the will is called the executor of the will, then we can read in the tomorrow class rights and obligation of legatee and legators. Both the things are there. Rights and obligation of legator or legatee. One's right is another one's duty. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
So that we'll see in the tomorrow class. And rights and obligation of legator and legatee in the tomorrow class. So that is the thing which I want to make it out. Then again, I will show you the same thank you which I already made over there, but I already closed
thank you,
this thank with this. Yes,
thank
this
you,
is
sir.
The thing. Yeah, this is the thanks which I made over there. And thank you very much for patient listening. And the 2 minutes I already crossed because now time is 3:32. And please inform the others so long that I will be free. I am at your disposal. Once I will be in a busy schedule, then you cannot expect my classes. Unless until there is a specific provision for that regard. Unless until there is a specific regard over there. With this, I would like to take your leave. Thank you very much and see you tomorrow. And have a good day and goodbye.